it taught financial literacy. And so a lot of people grow up living paycheck to paycheck because that's what they've seen.
Right.
We have a responsibility.
I am a witness to that.
To our children, to prepare them better for the future financially. If we're not doing that, we will continuously birth a generation of irresponsible people that don't know how to manage finances, and they're always going to find themselves in a hole.
That is true. That is true.
And I really believe that wholeheartedly, because even I just remember being really bad with money, and I got tired of it. You know what I'm saying? So I think we have to check ourselves. Even if you wasn't taught, grow the fuck up and, you know, create your own traditions, you know, prepare yourself for a better tomorrow.
Right.
And I think a lot of times we miss that because we're living in the moment. But if tomorrow comes and you just pulling lint out your pocket, you missed your opportunity.
Right.
You know, and I'm not saying that it's you're never too old or young to prepare. That's a call in. Okay. Who we got?
Sweet Leak P.
Who?
Somebody named Sweet Something, goddamn
it. Okay, Sweet Something. Talk to me.
Hey, Jackie, how you doing? This is Sweet Meat P.
We don't want what you're selling.
Get the fuck out.
So why is your meat sweet?
Sweet Meat P, get it right, baby. The legend is here.
All right. I'm listening.
So about finances, finances is all about the unit, baby. Not just my unit, but the unit of the two functional people. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying.
If you know what I'm saying? If the loving is good.
Oh, my God.
The finances are good.
The loving can be good and the finances might not be worth a damn.
Nah, baby. Nah, baby.
So you saying with the sweet meat that you laying, the finances is good, too.
There you go. You know about me, baby.
I don't know about you. I'm just going by what you say.
That's right, baby.
Oh, my God.
Ain't no thing but a chicken wing, but if you give me some grease, I'll slide your pee. Sweet Meat Pete.
Well, thank you very much, Sweet Meat Pete. I gotta make sure I'm saying that. Sweet Meat Pete.
That's right, baby.
And I got it right, I think. I think I got it right.
I'll see you on the down low, baby.
On the down low.
You know how we go.
That's how we go.
Is there anything that you want to tell us, like, right now? I mean,
according to Sweet Meat Pete, he done already told y'all. So,
yeah,
I don't think there's nothing else left for me to say, according to Sweet Meat Pete.
Come on, player. You know how it is, man.
I see.
Look.
I wish I could see.
Oh, you see.
Of course,
you couldn't see in the dark. But
is that what
see?
It was? He had to clap and I couldn't
when
see.
When the loving is good, all is well in the hood.
Oh, man.
Goodbye.
Oh, man.
Thank you for the call, Sweet Meat. Sweet. We appreciate it. I ain't feel
you
like
that's it
all
shit.
Of that, right?
You just busted your stove. You used to call that man Sweet Meat.
I just called him Sweet Meat because that's what he said. Sweet Meat Pete.
Sweet Meat Pete.
Now people going to be asking me all kind of questions about Sweet Meat Pete.
I'm asking it now.
He did the talking. I didn't own to anything. He did the talking.
Yeah, but the way you was moving in the chair, like, okay.
Because it's hot as hell in here. I don't know sweet if meat. I got, because of the scarf, it's hot in here.
Okay, Sweet Meat.
Sweet
okay,
Meat.
Okay, Sweet Meat.
Well, that's what he introduced himself as, so what else am I supposed to call him?
Sweet.
And why is his meat sweet?
He act like don't nobody know. I'm just saying. I should be asking y'all. Because y'all got more of a kick out of it than I did.
Hey.
I'm just saying.
The man called
y'all
and
like
said,
sweet meat.
The man called and said,
that's
you
like
know
sweet
what it
daddy
is, baby.
For those of you that watch Good Times, Sweet Daddy.
You know what it is, baby.
Oh, maybe I'm telling my age because they looking at me like, who?
You know what it is, baby. Oh, no.
Sweet Daddy.
Jackie, you in trouble.
Yeah, but
he played that part. Yeah, I looked at him the other night. I said, you know what? When they gave you that, you played that part.
Yeah,
you played that part.
Perfect.
You played that. Better than That's My Mama. He was on there too.
But he was just Cliff or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, but we done got off topic. So I think that when you're dating and getting to know someone, I think definitely finances should come up in the conversation. Now, if it's just a casual date, you know what I'm saying? Y'all, it's just like one of those booty calls that y'all call it. Then I guess it's not really necessary. Because you're not looking to build a partnership with that person. But if it's somebody that you're interested in going the next level with, you got to talk about finances. It's a must. Otherwise, it's like you're setting yourself up for failure. If she's the one that's saving and you go out and spend every dime that you earn, you're working against the unit.
Okay, so let me ask you a question. Let's say he's spending every dime, but he's making sure that those bills are paid. Is he still working against the unit?
If he's making sure the bills are paid.
If he's making sure
and
the
then
rent
he's
paid.
Spending whatever's left over.
Yeah, exactly.
If he's spending whatever's left over, how much of whatever's left over is he putting up for the future?
Now, that's
are you preparing for a tomorrow, or are you just my bills are paid so I can blow the rest of the money?
Some people, you got some people that live for tomorrow, and you got some people that says, you know what, we don't know what tomorrow gonna bring.
Well,
so you got to live for today.
And
you
then
know?
Tomorrow comes and then you're hit with, financial emergency. And you don't have anything because you said fuck tomorrow.
Well, I don't think that people are saying fuck tomorrow. I just think that they just feel like tomorrow is not promised.
Well, I think that tomorrow isn't promised, but does that mean I'm going to blow all my goddamn money today? And just in case tomorrow does come, I don't have anything to buy food or anything else. I mean,
I think it comes down to being responsible.
Dumb. Yeah.
That's dumb. You know?
You're a teenager and you're living like that. That's different, you know. But when you're older with adult responsibilities, I think that you should be a bit more responsible and thinking about the future. If you have children, don't you want to put money up for your children?
True.
I mean, I'm just asking, you know. Are you currently in a relationship?
Me personally?
You don't even want to my left.
Oh, do.
Okay. Was that a trick question?
No, I'm not in a relationship right now. I'm not in a relationship right now.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, and I don't want you to go all into detail, but in previous relationships, was finances something that you all discussed?
It was. It was one of those. It wasn't a conversation where it was just a fly. You know, one of those fly by night conversations.
Okay.
We have it and then we don't have it no more.
Right.
It was one of those sit down conversations where she knew my finances. I knew hers.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the one thing that I can say about her is that we were a great help to each other on a financial tip.
Okay.
She helped me tremendously. Mm-hmm. On the financial tip, wherever she saw that it was a need.
Okay.
Wherever I saw that there was a need, because I knew everything about her.
Mm-hmm.
That I would be there to help her. I think a lot of the situations coming along with me is that when things would go on with the car, she didn't have to worry about that.
Right.
You know what
right.
I'm saying? So But on the financial tip, yeah, it was this is just honestly saying this on the radio, that it was an equal situation.
That's what's up.
It was an equal situation, and it was never a situation where, you know, how I give you, let's say me and you in a relationship and I give you money, that it was never a loan.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? If I rock with you, that means if I gave it to you, I'm not looking for it back.
Yeah.
Now, if you're giving it back to me because you know me as far as that I may have a bill coming up,
mm-hmm.
then that may be a different story. You
right.
know what I'm saying? Because one thing about her is she would know that I didn't want the money back. So what she would do is she knew my cell phone account. She knew the account to BG&E. So she would just go ahead and put it on that. You know what I'm saying? So you actually beat me to what I was going to do, but I didn't ask you for the money back. You know what I'm saying? So, but most relationships right now, it's not.
Well, they're struggling because they're not talking about finances.
There's loans.
I'm so old school. You know what I mean? If I'm in a relationship and you need help, I got it. I don't mind helping. And, you know, the person that I would be dating hopefully would feel the same. But if I gave it to you, I'm not going to say, remember, I gave you, where's my money?
Right.
Know, because ultimately, it's about the team.
I feel like if a person has to, I use me and you, for example, because we're two different sex. That if me and you in a relationship, if I got to ask you...
You don't want to use Nick?
Huh?
Hell no. She crazy, yo.
I really could not resist that. You know what I'm saying? But go ahead.
I'm like Kermit the Frog over here
sipping on this fucking tea.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay, but so...
What I'm saying is that if you have to say to a person, hey, where's that money I loaned you?
That's being petty.
Like, you know,
Unless y'all establish that in the very beginning of the relationship, that's different. But I do think that that's really being petty. Rich says finances and cars is more of a breakup than infidelity in relationships nowadays. I would definitely say finances because people are tap dancing around that conversation, and maybe because they're so busy on the feel good side of the relationship that they don't want to rock the boat by discussing finances, but it will ultimately be a detriment in your relationship if you're not having these discussions. Who's that? Hi, Full of Grace. Jason says, can you talk about finances if you don't feel like you're in a real relationship? Well, would it be a point in discussing finances if you're not thinking of that person going to the next level? Or should you, you know? If it's just a fuck buddy, is it necessary to have financial conversations?
No.
Yeah.
No.
Because the two parties already understand what this is about.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Let's not complicate
this shit.
You know what I'm saying?
You already know what you're coming in the door one.
Exactly. So, no, I don't think it's necessary. But if you're in because it seems like it's degrees to this shit.
Well,
you know?
the reason why you don't want to do that is because if you all are coming in and y'all just fuck buddies and she find out that you make a whole hell of a lot more money than her, now it ain't no more of that she just with you because she enjoys being with you. Now she's with you because of the money that you're bringing towards the table and how she can gain that.
Now listen, because in that statement,
I thought you was going to say, you know,
like
what, that is so
saying
true.
That all women, if the man is making more money, would then begin to plot on his finances, and I think that's kind of a sexist statement. Because some of y'all jokers do the plotting as well. you know, if you're out in a club and you see a couple of guys, I done seen this happen to a couple of people. Guys say, can you buy me a drink? I think I even had a guy ask, could I buy him a drink? And I was just like, I was looking at him like, he must be joking. But he was serious. And so don't make it seem like it's just the women that's out here looking for financial gain, because there are some men that are out like that too.
No, I didn't say that it was just a...
But you imply that if she realizes you make more, I know, but you used that scenario, so I want to talk about that shit, because some of you motherfuckers are shady too. So... Full of Grace said, you wouldn't want to connect yourself to someone financially, to someone who doesn't feel like a real relationship. Absolutely. Thank you for your comment. If it's just understood that you all are fucking, then there's no need to discuss finances. But don't act like, you know, that women are the only ones that get in their feelings either, because some of y'all get in y'all feelings too. Once it's over, as it most likely be, you'll have unnecessary bond to the person. I agree. I completely agree.
I agree.
So we got another caller. I can't wait to hear what they have to say on finances. Ain't nothing. Can we get that? Ain't nothing going on but the rent. Who's that?
Caller, you can talk.
Hey, how y'all doing? This is Mac, one of Nate's followers and one of his co-workers.
Okay, how you doing? Thank you for calling.
You know he don't got no job. They don't never make no uniform.
Okay, that is Tommy all the way.
Man, don't say that.
It's
$100,000 business going on.
Damn.
we don't want to say the numbers too much, but as far as finances in a relationship, you know what? The generation has changed that. Because, and I'm like this. I feel though, if you get any kind of relationship, everybody got to have their own money. You put what's in the pot, because a lot of times it depends on the woman, how she was raised. Because a lot of women think a man's supposed to take care of, and they ain't supposed to be like that. So for that, and then we got some players out there that boosted up back in the 60s and 70s and all like that, when you had your hustlers. You had your dope boys and all like that, taking care of them girls and used to kicking out. So it's a generation thing. But technically, if you want to be in a solid relationship, you know, you got to have your own money. And that we do get caught up and between male and female. But at the same time, when I get involved with a woman, we got to talk finance. We definitely, because you want to take it to that level. But I don't think nobody owes anything. You got to do your soul search on, and that goes for male and female, where that person been, so you know where they going at. Because I'm like, yes, I won't mess with no woman if she ain't got no money. And it should be vice versa. But some guys like to pawn it out there like, oh, baby, I can take care of this, I can take care of that. You know, and they spoil them women like that. Or it goes through generations where a lot of single moms, depended on that hustler, that ball out there, or that sugar daddy like that, and they was kicking it out like that. So they only get used to how you treat them. But me, a woman got to have some money. And they just got to have some money. If I'm going to put it to the table, and you slack down, you know, and you start falling, you know, and I don't show you a way how to bring it up and keep that money to the table, keep up with them bills, you got to go. And that goes for both. But sometimes a man can use it as his advantage, and a woman can use it as her advantage, because if she don't get it at home, she's going to get it somewhere else. It's been like that for 5 generations now. So it got to stop, really.
Well, I think it depends on the couple. That's what I'm going to say on it. What works for couple A may not work for couple B. And when I grew up,
sometimes you got to destroy all them scenarios and start from scratch.
Well, I think again, it depends on the couple.
If somebody started, it's like everything else. He's got to get rid of. He's been scoring. I get rid of
him. He's been scoring.
You ain't got no money to help pay the bills or get together and all like that. Then.
Here's what I'm going to say to that. I really appreciate your opinion, Mackie. And I think it's different for each couple. Now, I grew up in a time where my dad would bring his paycheck home to my mother. And it wasn't that my mother didn't work, but he would get a certain amount for himself. And then the rest of the money goes to the household. And that's always worked for them. And that's why I say it depends on the scenario. Even in my relationship, it's always been that way. But at the same time, it's like I know how to be a helpmate. I've always had my own. So I don't think it's necessarily always the woman looking for the man to take care of her or vice versa. I think that's a conversation that has to be had between the couple, and they decide or determine how that should go. I think that when you're in a relationship, you should always be able to count on your partner because it's about the team itself. It's not about just one person. And so if I'm looking at somebody like, oh, you got to be able to do this and you got to be able to do that. That's a conversation that we're going to have with one another. It might not work for you and it might not work for you, Nate, but it's a conversation that you have with one another to determine how it's going to best benefit the two of you.
That is true. But at the same time, that extra hand can always balance that out.
Oh, definitely. Because, I agree.
And definitely, back in certain times, yeah, a man relationship, they could do that at one time. You know, but I watched my parents go through something like that.
Uh-huh.
And after a while, when all six of us got a little older, that it couldn't cut it. So mom had to go out there.
Yeah.
But sometimes if you start from the beginning to the middle to the end, I mean, and then some people, the percentage of it is not like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it never was 100%, especially, I'm going to say, you know, with the black community. It never was 100%. You might say 20%. Always say between the 20s and 30%. You know, but if, you know, like I said, if, you know, like you said, it's always something that got to be talked about, but
right,
it got to come to a point where it should just stop. I mean, but some of us, we like the benefits of all the relationship, but the hardcore part about it and the relationship, the kids, all that follow behind it and them bills and all like that, you know, like somebody said, sometimes that money kills the relationship way
it does sometimes.
Even
yeah.
Well, let me ask you a question, Mac. You know, Jackie just said that her father would bring the money home to her mom. What do you think the role is for a man and woman as far as who support who?
I think long as she's budgeting and managing that money right, and like she said, because that can work. But also, but what about, it depends on how the budget is in the house. Is it enough to take care of everything? And as far as the kids and stuff like that, if his kids involved and stuff like that. But if it's just enough to take care of the kids and they never really have a real life,
mm-hmm,
where they can go and take trips and stuff like that, it, you know, after a while, it becomes strange. Because sometimes, some people, when they get in those kind of relationships, they never get a chance to see the world.
And maybe that's probably true for some, but, and I have to say this, I think the reason it was set up in their relationship because my mom was better with the finances. And yeah, we went on vacations. And a lot of times, like when school would get out, we would spend pretty much every summer in Florida. I mean, we went like all over the place, but the bulk of our summer was spent in Florida. So we didn't go without anything. It's just that was how it worked for them at that time. We live in a different day and age. I'm sure there's still couples out there that probably live that way, but I think it depends on that couple. It might not work for you, but it does work for some. And as long as there's that party that is responsible, that makes sure that all the bills are taken care of and there's money left over, if it works for you, fine. If it doesn't, find something that does, because it's kind of, it's different for everybody, you know. But I definitely appreciate your point of view.
Oh yeah, no doubt.
Thank you for calling in. I love when men call in, because we always get women.
I like running the business, and Buddy the Man is my business, and Buddy the Man is my own home.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and you know, sometimes I think I'm just that type person.
Right.
I don't think a woman can do it unless she was on my same level.
Gotcha. You know?
That's how I look at it.
Let me
ask you this question, Matt, before you leave. So, yeah. Let's say if a man and a woman in a relationship, and a woman is supposed to, let's say a woman help a man or a man help a woman or whatever, and let's say the woman or the man says, well, my children come first. Who comes first, the children or the help me?
I think the man always gonna come to church in the household all the time. The man has to come first. Because without that man, if he leave with example here, he has to be providing and ensuring that everybody in that family, from the kids on up, that and even especially the boy, because that's the boy. Once that man shows the boy discipline and respecting that woman, and the woman show them boys. But nurture and respect that woman, and always teach them boys. You know, when you with women, you respect them. Yes. No means no. And say if it's girls involved, they gonna look up to their father how a woman treats a man and how he runs a household. So that man always comes first in that family. Now, as far as how things distributed, you know, as far as like when it comes down to sitting dinner and all like that, you know, the head always gets fed. But the kids and moms eat first. You know, it's a balanced thing. But when you start talking at seeing other females and letting them know that certain things, that's how certain things supposed to be. That's how it is. No, a lot of people don't teach that kind of stuff anymore.
I agree.
You know.
Yeah, I agree.
I'm an old young person, but you know, but. You know, now and then I let them guys know, and them females know, you know, this is where it's worth. A man ain't really supposed to be taking care of no woman. Really. Who's supposed to take care of him? You don't, really. And then, you know, one day we're going to get on a subject with a woman's real purpose on this earth.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, now I can't, hold up, I can't wait to talk. Let me just say this, because hold up. Let me say this. What, before you go, what's a woman's real purpose? Because I got to know that. What's a woman's real purpose? Because here's what I'm going
to
say.
To serve the man in the kitchen and the bedroom. I'm going to say it just like that. That's it.
He's single.
That's it.
That's exactly why. What else can
y'all do for us?
But he was married.
I can probably tell you why he's not.
We have to romance it, sugarcoat it. But I'm gonna tell you this: 9 out of 10, if that woman ain't doing what she's supposed to at home, that's why that man don't be there. That's why. That's the number one thing. If they don't really. I hope I ain't offend a lot of people.
Well, you didn't offend, but you took us back probably 50 years. Because here's what I'm going to say. There's no man on the face of the earth that could ever do what a woman does. We are the givers of life. And it's kind of like that attitude that sets us so... Listen to what I'm saying. I'll let you talk. That sets us so far back when you say a woman's place is in the bedroom or in the kitchen, because we are so much more than that. Without us, you wouldn't be here. You know what I'm saying? And I think men need to understand that we are so much more than that. We are givers of life. What man can do that?
That's understood. That's said, because...
So I'm don't like, say bro, that we're limited to the bedroom in the kitchen, because you couldn't bear our level of pain. That's what I'm saying. That is such sexist bullshit.
He split it.
First of all, let me say this because you need to go back to creation. What I'm going to say on this is that we have life long before y'all fertilize an egg. Let me say that. So we are much more than the kitchen and the bedroom.
When you go all the way back to science, when we was in the water, we was reproducing. It's still incest reproduced without the male or female. So we was made out of something. But
all men pass through a woman's leg. Let's establish that. And that alone, we should always be put on a pedestal. That right there.
But I understand it, and I commend that part. I'm not going to deny that. But you still cannot come through that leg if we don't go up in that leg.
You're missing the point. Here's the point that you're missing. We have life.
Gotta get short. Gotta get short.
Before you fertilize that egg, do you understand? Oh, I should be reading the sign. I just was banging on the table, right? But we have life long before you make that connection, my brother.
We gotta get you on the show, man.
Look.
I got to read some of these comments because it even took an hour on the damn show.
You got to remember, before a woman, it had to be some kind of reproduction to change the genetics to make humans. If you look at the science for it, it might have took a billion years for us to split up like that so we can make more when we got here on land. If you do the science of it. I know the science of it, and that's why I'm telling you,
and it has nothing to do with the Bible. What I'm saying is we are created with life in us. Exactly. But what we need to bring to the forefront is a man, but we are born with life within.
And that goes back to the science part.
Here we go.
You know, it's some animals, it's some incense out there.
Oh God!
without the male.
Let me read some of these comments.
You know, but that's how it is. But you know what? I'm gonna get back to you on that. I'm gonna get back to me.
Do your research. Get back to me.
Oh God!
How we came split between man and woman when we came out.
Do your research.
Man, we're gonna get you. We're gonna take the next caller. We're gonna get you on the show, man.
Since we here on Earth, we need one or the other to make them kids. I don't care how you do it.
I'm not disputing the man's part.
Okay.
But what I'm saying is that we have life. You got another caller?
21st century.
Yeah.
Without one or the other, we can't make no life.
All right, thanks, Matt. We appreciate you, bro.
Yeah, thank you for calling in, Mackie.
Thank you for calling.
I love y'all still. I really love you.
Thank you so much. We appreciate you. Thank you.
I really do. Y'all keep up the good work.
All right, man.
All right. Let me read Grace's comment because she said she wanted to know what are we doing. So, Grace, you're listening. Full of Grace, you're listening to the Intimacy Chronicles. So, we broadcast live every Monday from 7 p.m. to 8:30. And we talk about a wide range of topics. I'm so glad that you tuned in tonight. first of all, before we go to the song that we're going to feature tonight, can we hear There's Nothing Going On But The Rent?
Oh, what was that, y'all?
It was a nice beat.
Nice beat my ass.
I did try to throw that.
Yeah, I know you did. Nice beat my ass. That was y'all fucking anthem. That was y'all fucking
anthem. Yeah, I got to read this because this is really good.
I don't got it.
He ain't got it.
See, that's that bullshit where he don't get no nookie for that. See? Well, Full of Grace say, if you have a man who takes care of the finances, you got to be the woman making him almighty to be able to be that man. Absolutely. And that's another thing because sometimes we can be hard on men. But if that man goes out every day and he's the provider, you got to make him feel like the king when he walked through that door.
Amen.
If you ain't doing that, you falling short on your wifely duty.
Amen.
You are not fulfilling your end of the team obligation.
Amen. Corner.
That's right. Ain't nothing going on but the rent, baby. Over there jiggy with it? It looked like you was bouncing a little bit.
It got a nice beat.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Got a nice beat. I'm just saying.
She made a good point though, because sometimes some of these women be trifling, man.
Boy, nothing in life is free.
That's all the fuck I'm gonna play on that.
Exactly. Thank you.
All right, I just wanted a little something, something. But
can you,
we get ready.
Can you play no more scrubs? I mean, pigeons.
No
more pigeons.
No, wait a minute. You said no more scrubs. The scrub is the guy sitting on the passenger side.
I met pigeons.
So tonight, after he plays this next, you can maybe play something else?
Pigeons.
There you go.
Hey, this the thing song for us, man. This is what the fuck
pigeons.
We want.
I'm outnumbered here tonight.
Getting
some head. That got a nice beat too,
though.
Whatever.
You see the rhythm of it?
Whatever. I said I had a nice beat. I said I'm kind of over here bouncing a little bit. My live getting ready to time out. So tonight we're going to feature a song called You're Boring. And I'm proud of the tune. It's really hot. It's produced by my younger brother. Follow him on Facebook at DJ_MB. It really is a hot song. So I'm going to let Nick go ahead and put it on. Yeah, Jason.
No, don't come over here. I'm serious.
You got the sauce all on your cheeks.
Oh, yeah. Now you want to be all on me. When we was in the club, you was dashing out. What was up with that?
What you mean, what was up with me at the club? The club ain't my scene. I like to go to the club, take care of my business, talk to the people I need to talk to, put it down like that. Everybody checking you, checking me, all flashy and shit. That's not my thing.
You're just boring, that's all.
Maybe, baby, asking questions when you know what's up. I'm stressing how you dressing when we stepping, cause they notice us. Hold the pump, no faking, I'm debating how I wanna move. Number steady, doubling these bubble heads, they wanna choose. I'm wrong with you cause you a compliment. Can't confirm my confidant, I love it cause you confident, astonishing. You outstanding like the Gap and say, but you think I'm pouring like a can of flash champagne. Damn, I try to do a different, show you I'm dope, but you bougie, only moving to the musical flow. Your hook is the blow, making Snapchat videos, curving niggas like a picture. I get the picture, you know how you holding that, you holding back. Suppose I'm whack, you bargain, keep it cold for stat. Never overreacting for nothing. When we touching, it's something I feel you let go. Otherwise, you just did not get it, but let the best know. Word. Feel right than what it feel like. She call me boring, but I'm scoring and we still tight. Feel right than what it feel like. She call me boring, but I'm scoring and we still took the damage. You Instagram and trying to please the masses, and I ain't on that type of time like the ground rather. Word. Perhaps it's a block or something. Stop the front and truthfully, this honest conversation, no debating, it's just you and me. Yeah. Pick the situation and the woman that you choose to be. Your vision blurred using my words, move stupidly, but who is me? Oh. I ain't your father, won't bother usually, but I can see you caught up in laws, you flaws frugally. Fashion overroller, do your thing, baby. I ain't mad at you, but check the attitude before you listen. I ain't hype enough, make my life adjust. Light the blunt type of stuff, show that you bugging. It's something I ain't liking, but couldn't put my finger on it. Nope. It's danger on it. Nah. But me being me, stupid niggas still ignore it. Dummy. Of course it's a marathon, but early on I forfeit. Cause shorty got me when they trying to dip and I ain't boring. What? Feel right than what it feel like. She call me boring, but I'm scoring and we still tight. feel right, then what it feel like? She call me boring, but I'm scoring and we still tight.
I'm supposed to take this and go shopping?
If I'm so boring, then what you doing? Why you with me?
First of all, I ain't impressed by that. I'm with you because I'm boring too.
Oh, from an air.
I think that might be our next topic.
What did it want from an air?
That was my song back then.
I ain't gonna lie.
That was my shit.
Let me tell you like this. When that song came out, that shit had me counting on my hands,
but that's
toes and shit.
Yeah.
Like, damn, he had a lot of fucking women.
But that CD, that whole CD was nice.
Yes.
It was nice.
I'm a musician. So the bass in the song had me going. Like,
if you listen to that CD, that shit was the bomb.
Brother, he said some brother? Real shit on this song, too.
Yeah, exactly.
That's your brother?
Yeah, Mike produced it.
Mike. That shit was hot.
Yeah, that shit is hot.
That's hot, yo.
Yeah, it was just released yesterday.
I might have to put that shit on rotation.
Yeah.
Let me tell you like this. That's the kind of shit that I will be blasting in my fucking truck.
That's what I'm saying. That during shit the summertime, was so hot.
Driving down the road like, oh, you don't know who this is?
Hey,
oh,
Brandon.
Bitch, you boy.
You're
that shit was
later.
Nice. I mean, it was nice.
Yo,
the tune that we just played was called "Your Boring." It was produced by DJ underscore MB. That's his Instagram of Rowhouse Brothers. It's a hot ass track. You'll probably see me post it on my wall because it's so hot. When he sent it to me yesterday, like, my chest was out like the proud big sister, like, God damn, you really doing your shit. So thank you for playing it. Now, we were talking about finances for some of you that joined us later. By the way, we have a winner, someone that met all the qualifications. So I'm going to shout her out. It's Bridget Nunez. She followed. She subscribed. She did everything that was required. I said anybody that could follow directions could win a prize. So, Bridget, you're the recipient of our Valentine's Day giveaway. Yay. Can we get the cheer?
Okay, Bridget.
Yay, Bridget Nunez.
Okay, Bridget.
You are the winner of our Valentine's Day giveaway. Next week, we'll be giving away another gift bag, probably with the same qualification. So thanks again. We definitely appreciate all of you for listening, but we're gonna get back to Al.
Yes, Bridget, you are the winner. Yes,
I want to know
Bridget.
How Bridget look.
Bridget Hold is on. A fox. I'll let fi- me tell I'll, you I'll Bridget is a fox, but I'll she's a right married now. Fox, let me just say that.
I'm not gonna find out right now.
That's right.
So yeah, thanks a lot, Bridget.
Let me tell y'all what Bridget wins. If you tuning in late, a bottle of wine, $25 gift card. I think it's like 6 different restaurants included on that gift card. Free 3-day, 2-night giveaway. The autographed book by Stan Long called Blackbird Medley, The Transformation of a Gangster. So all of that is included in her goodie bag. So Bridget, I will contact you after the show so we can make arrangements to get you your bag.
Yeah, yeah, that you and your husband can go on, or boyfriend or whatever.
Yeah,
I know.
So
thanks a lot, Bridget.
You two can be a winner if you tune in next Monday and follow the directions. You two could be a winner. So I'll post that again tonight for next week's giveaway. We'll be giving away a gift bag every week leading up to Valentine's Day.
And for those who just tuning in, the bag has already been won by Bridget, who's married.
She said you ain't got to put on her goddamn business.
Thanks a lot, Bridget!
So, yeah, that, that's fun. I mean, I like that we can that we're able to give something away. It's just our way of saying thank you for tuning into the show every week. There'll be plenty more giveaways to come, but this is our special Valentine's Day giveaway. You already said, Nick. Since we're on Valentine's Day, what are y'all Valentine's Day traditions?
I'm gonna start with Nick. Can you play that?
You know, I'm gonna make that a drop.
Wait a minute. Since you're playing that, now I know Alligator Arms ain't about to say some shit. Let me tell you why he's Alligator Arms. You seen the commercial, Nick?
The Geico commercial.
With the he's so busy eating, but when the check comes, he's talking about I would grab it, but my arms are too short.
But then at the end, yo dip down and eat the pot.
Right, exactly.
That's not me.
That is you.
Get the fuck out of here.
That is you.
Okay, so I've never paid a bill?
One bill. And
we only been out a couple of times.
I got to remember that the rest of our lifetime.
Now, this is my motto for Valentine's Day.
That is that after you done shelled out the finance? I was the kind of girl to
make it toast. Yeah.
Okay. Bridget said, oh shit, first sweet meat, now alligator arms. Yeah, we got some characters.
First of all, Bridget, I don't have alligator arms, shit. Okay? We know that you won. We know you showing off because you won. But hit it for me, Nick. Thanks a lot, Bridget!
Oh my God, they're so crazy. So, we had Donna was supposed to do our financial segment tonight. She got stuck on the side of the road with a flat tire, so she'll join us next Monday. She really is probably like a financial guru. And I take a lot of advice from her because she knows her shit. So I wanted to share that with everybody, but she'll be joining us next Monday as a result. But yeah, y'all didn't share your Valentine's Day traditions. Nick, don't get distracted. What's your Valentine's Day tradition? Because Nick is in a relationship, so.
Yo, let me tell you like this. Whoever made that.
Right, exactly.
Yo, she is sucking souls out.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
She is sucking.
She need to give a training class.
I'd be afraid to get head from this one. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you be standing outside her door.
I'm sorry. I'd be a skeleton. Getting some head. Damn. Nah.
Lord have mercy. Now, I'm not. I can't even concentrate with the sound effects right now because Nick on one.
I need some time with your laptop after the show. I need some time with your laptop.
Lord have mercy.
I need some time with your laptop after the show. I'm just saying. No, I mean my tradition is, you know, when I was in a relationship, I mean. Well, see, you kind of figure when you start talking about traditions. See, this is the part that we have messed up on. That men and women, I've physically seen, they break their necks getting flowers and balloons and candy. I mean, all in the line, getting this and getting that or whatever. Like, so. The day before Valentine's Day, wasn't Valentine's Day?
And that's the point that I make a lot of times. If you are doing these things throughout the year, one day shouldn't make or break you.
The day after Valentine's Day is not Valentine's Day no more?
It's so commercial.
I'm just trying to understand.
Yeah.
If you're doing it 364 days a year, the 365th day should be... I would say a little extra special.
Oh, my goodness.
A little extra special to show, you know, that you I really appreciate
yeah,
you.
I agree.
That you are
I
my
agree.
Fine wine and dine, you know, that you my dime piece. But every day should be Valentine's
yeah, I agree.
Day. You know what I'm saying? And if you don't know how to do it, if she was to say, well, you ain't show me no Valentine's Day the day before yesterday, I didn't. Go over to the light switch. Turn the bitch on and off and say happy Valentine's Day.
Because the shit on.
I'm just... I'm just saying.
I mean, but I had to agree with you. I think if you're doing those things all year round, you really shouldn't have to go so hard on that actual day. You know, I mean, you can go hard, you know.
See, this is what I do on Valentine's. I play this shit.
We're expecting you.
Dressed up.
Yeah, I put on my bow tie, my Chipping Down outfit.
Lord have mercy.
Let me tell you.
Lap dance.
With some football slingshots. You know, the cup.
Oh, my God, really?
Let me tell you. When this man made this song, I don't care if you were white, black, Puerto Rican, Spanish, or whatever, this song made you shake your ass. Like, yes.
The Love Bowl, yes.
You got into
yes.
this shit.
Yes, indeed.
You
even
got into
now.
That shit.
Even now, it just
even
came
now,
on.
You get
like,
into that shit.
Exactly.
Now, some of you young bucks who don't know what the fucking Love Bowl is, fuck y'all.
Exactly.
We know what it is. You know what I'm saying? But this right here, hell fucking yeah.
That's the shit. Won't hurt it timed
anymore.
Out.
Won't hurt anymore.
It's an open smile.
Yeah. That's so crazy because I think that every year the stores are making a killing. But I also think
this
people go out.
Money.
Yeah, I think a lot of times people go out because they're not doing those things. And they use that day and Christmas to kind of make up for the shit that they wasn't doing during the year. But
oh, don't forget another one.
Mother's Day.
No.
What did I say? Christmas.
You said Christmas.
Valentine's Day. And Mother's
one
Day.
More, and there's one more. Anniversary.
Well, anniversary is a given,
oh, baby.
I think. Because you're celebrating the years together. So I think that's a little different.
Yeah, but you know, men get criticized.
Yeah.
When you forget your anniversary.
Because how could you get that? And I think that for me, yeah, I want to know how in the hell do you forget a significant day like that? Fuck Christmas, fuck Valentine's Day, but anniversary should be at the top of your list.
I agree. Now, let me ask you this question. Are women so caught on different things? When I say different things, I mean like, let's say we're in a relationship, and after 6 months, we made it official. Is that the anniversary?
I think that, the date that you actually make it official.
Okay. Now, is there another anniversary on the first time that I tell you I love you?
I don't go by me because I'm probably not
shit,
like
yo. That's what I want to know.
A lot of women. I'm not with all of that shit the first time we kissed, the first time we went out on a date. I really don't give a damn about any of that.
You know, I mean, yeah. I'm not going to remember the first time you ate off my plate. No, I will remember that.
You will remember that.
I will. I didn't need the
I'm
amen
sorry.
Call. I didn't need the
I got,
amen call.
I got lost
I didn't
in
need
translation.
The amen.
What the fuck?
I didn't need the amen. I
got caught up, Nick. I got caught up in the moment.
Yeah, I didn't
okay?
need the amen call. I didn't need that corner.
My bad. I got caught up.
Because I was correcting my damn self. I didn't need, you know, she hopped right on my back. Like, yeah.
Yeah,
she was in it. She was in it to win it.
Yeah,
hell yeah. I'll be eating off his motherfucking plate. I'm just saying. I mean, like, I'm not with all of that.
I mean, what gift do you give? A fork?
Or a muzzle so that she can't do it again. You would give a muzzle. I can see it. You petty like that. But I know
Trump.
People that celebrate all of those things. And I feel like to each his own. But I don't need all of that. I'm really simple. You know, I'm going to celebrate when we became official.
Yes, and I'm going to tell you that this song right here, I don't give a fuck how old you are. When this song come on and it's your anniversary, this song right here does, it does something to you.
Even when it ain't your anniversary, the shit do something
it
to you.
It does something to you. Yeah. Yeah. Yes.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. So,
Tony.
Yeah, absolutely. I think a lot of times we put so much emphasis on things that it begins to cause stress in the relationship. Oh, you didn't remember this, or you didn't remember that. And I think all that isn't necessary, especially right. If that person is showing you love throughout the year. But I do think anniversary is a big deal. But not all this other shit. The first time we kissed, first time you took me out on a date. I personally don't give a damn about none of that shit.
All right, so let's do this. Who the fuck keeps counts of that shit? Is it the men or the women?
The women.
Because I couldn't tell you what the fuck my anniversary is. I couldn't tell you.
Well, I think you're going to be in the doghouse.
Yeah, you're going
to. That's some real shit. I just be in that motherfucker.
Now, I will remember. I do remember mine's. When we were in a relationship,
mm-hmm.
ours were in February.
Okay.
Around the 14th or the 15th of February.
Oh, that's pretty easy.
I do remember that.
Yeah.
I do remember that. So I do remember that. So
I ain't counting no anniversary till we married. Real talk.
Okay. I mean, I really believe that you shouldn't have to be worried about the anniversary at least until you're married.
I agree with you on that.
You know what I'm saying?
I completely agree.
I mean, because now if you're in a relationship with somebody and they forget your birthday, is that a red flag?
It's a red flag, because then you start to wonder
how much they think.
Exactly.
And are they really paying attention?
Exactly.
But then that would, in some cases, some people would say that's the same thing for anniversary.
It's not really, though. It's your anniversary because you're married, you know.
But Casey got a rare condition of Alzheimer's, an early
sighting. Is that what you're claiming? He tried to slide that shit in.
I'm surprised he ain't got the Law and Order joint.
He tried to slide that bullshit in. But yeah, anniversary and birthday, because those are special. And I think that really those are the two you should put emphasis on. I think it begins to get a bit chaotic when you start thinking, oh, the first time we went out on a date, first time you kissed me, then Christmas and Valentine's Day. You know, if you take care anniversary and birthday and do little small shit throughout the year, I think you should be good. I think sometimes when you're in a relationship for a long time, sometimes you get complacent and may feel like you don't have to do those things. But I'd say both parties want to feel special at some point. That's just my thoughts on it. I think as women, we shouldn't always be looking to be on the receiving end, because we got to make that man feel like he's the king too.
Well, you have men who never have no problem in giving if we know that the receiving.
Here we go.
If we know that the receiving is coming right behind it.
So that, which brings me to a question. Are you giving only to receive?
We're giving.
Because that's what you just said.
We're giving in the hopes of receiving. But we already, I mean, let me speak for me. I love to give. I love to give to them. Yeah, that's right. That's right.
I just needed to know, because.
Right. Come on down. You are the next contestant of the Date Price is Right.
Lord help us.
You can win a bag of tea bags.
Lord, listen. He didn't bring that shit up all night, and here you go. Now ain't thinking about it.
Tea bags.
That's what you want your Valentine's Day gift to be. or you ain't getting it. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. Oh my gosh.
Oh, shit.
Now, since we're talking about the teabagging. Because Nick brought it up.
No, we're not going to go there.
Nick brought it up. Is that what you look for on Valentine's Day? Special occasions? Or is that something that you require all throughout the year?
I want a teabag on Valentine's Day. Some special woman.
Lipton.
And it's going to be that
Lipton
kind of.
Lipton or Spice. I had a moment. I went somewhere.
Nah, yo, so. Fucking margarita, man. You don't drink no more before you come here, okay?
Actually, I only had like the small one. I ain't want them to supersize me tonight.
Oh, you would never meet here.
No, but the last time I went there, that's what I had.
This one?
Oh my God, yes. That's what damn. I had. I was like, no, I don't want that tonight.
Yeah, damn.
So, but yeah, I think for me, like, Valentine's Day is okay. I think for the most part, what I want on Valentine's Day, if I get something, I love peppermint patties. So just give me a box of peppermint patties. They come in a heart shape this time.
That
of
is
year.
Your sensation?
That's, yes.
That is your sensation?
Taste the sensation.
So what happens when you bite into one?
I feel the sensation. Like I'm riding, like I'm skiing on the slope. I love that. I'm simple. I'm simple. That's my point. You don't have to go out and get me lavish gifts because that's not my shit. But if you buy me a box of peppermint patties, you put thought into that. You listen because you know that's what I like. If you get something I'm not going to use just for the sake of saying you bought something, I think that's bullshit and you didn't put any thought into
and
it.
And, you know, you got to admit that Jackie is very original. You know what I'm saying? Any woman want turtles or the chocolate with the cherries in it or whatever, she says peppermint patties. So she got the best of both worlds.
Here we go.
The best of both worlds is that she loves her chocolate and her breath will smell good.
Minty fresh.
I've had peppermint patties.
They are bomb.
They.
And I like mine cold. I put mine in the refrigerator. Here we go. I can't with these two. Sweet meat. I need you next week because these two be off the chain. They be off the chain.
You gotta love
it. He's speechless.
No, I'm gonna tell you, you gotta love it because we've been missing out on this laughter and the side effects
and
shit.
Yeah, we had a two-week hiatus.
Like, you know what I'm saying? I mean, we got a genius over here. So,
oh, yeah.
You know, I mean, shout out to my man Big Nick, man. DJ Big Nick. But peppermint patties, like, you don't find too many women that eat those still. And
yeah,
for you
that
to say that you
favorite.
And for you
my
to say and then you say they come in a heart now?
Yeah, this time of year it's a heart shape.
You know what day is?
This
time of the year everything gets big.
Everything?
Hey, but they said they were going to discontinue them joints.
Really?
Or was it the little ones. With the little notes
yeah,
on it?
Yeah, they're doing the big ones now, right?
Yeah, but they about to discontinue
they about
them.
To, yeah.
Yeah, yo.
As a whole?
Donald Trump, yo.
That motherfucker. Now he got to go.
Now
he got to go.
Motherfucker re-elect
him. Now he got to go now, right?
Yeah, he got to go.
He can write discontinue the motherfuckers for real?
Yeah.
Peppermint patties for real?
The heart-shaped
joints with the little notes, like, I love you on it.
Yeah.
And give
well, that's
me some
he
head shit
have a
like that on it. You know me.
Damn.
Oh, sour puss motherfucker.
Damn.
So, yeah, that's, you know, that's pretty much, that's what I request for Valentine's Day.
You sure you wouldn't want no candy dick?
No.
You sure?
Yeah, there's no sensation.
I mean, but it's
fruity. I want the peppermint patty.
But it's fruity. You can suck on it all night.
Mm-mm.
You don't want no chocolate dip nuts?
Nah, peppermint patty.
That a bitch.
No chocolate.
I
bag.
Like that white sensation.
Ain't that a bitch?
You don't want no Hershey bag.
Ain't that a bitch?
I wondered when y'all was gonna catch it.
Yeah, I caught it. She want that white sensation.
I want that
thank
white
you,
sensation.
Bob is my. I'm gonna get Bob Bach in this
cool
bitch.
That cool breeze in my mouth.
That, damn.
I'm just saying. Taste the sensation.
Damn. She said, when I bite into a York peppermint patty, I get the sensation.
Are you playing that? That I'm riding.
The great American hero.
Look at what's happened to me. Oh, my God.
Let me tell you. Let me tell you. As a child, fuck Superman. This was, he was it.
He was
for
it.
Me. I'm not even going to lie to you. Because wow. Because the great American hero was a normal guy.
Yeah.
That was just given powers. He was getting into his powers, but he was a normal guy that was just a normal fucking guy.
Yeah.
But he saved the world and he did what he needed to do. Man, fuck Superman. I'm being dead honest with you. Whenever he came on, I watched him.
You done got excited as shit, man.
Huh?
I said, you done got excited as shit.
Because, well, you got to understand.
You done thought of something now.
No, because let me tell you.
Now we got to get a breakdown of the hero and shit.
No, if you really listen.
We're going to have to do some hero show now.
No, yeah. What I'm saying is, if you really listen to the, if you really listen to the words, like, it damn near almost made you cry. Believe it or not, I'm walking on air. Never thought I would feel so free.
He just got some head.
Flying away on a wing and a prayer.
You just went into the whole shit, man.
I know, right? This shit. Oh.
That's your shit.
And then believe it or not, it's just me. Yeah, yeah.
There we go.
Believe it or not.
I'm just walking on air.
You got nipples.
Yeah, it did go up, didn't it? Never thought I would feel so.
Oh, my God. They in their feelings.
You know what? If you keep on playing that, y'all two got to step out.
You going to pull out the cape?
Let's move on.
I just got that visualization.
I usually get maybe one or two from her. She's batting five in a row, yo. Fucking five. Yo, could I be here in a minute? Damn.
Maybe, yeah, I probably miss you a little bit.
Damn, yo. She's batting five in a fucking row, yo.
I'm just saying. You about to do your...
Damn.
Okay. I think I'm going to put this challenge out to y'all. Since we're talking superheroes and shit, and y'all know I love a good costume. We're gonna do a superhero show, and y'all gonna come dressed as your favorite superhero. You can do whatever you like, as long as you come dressed up. Don't come in your birthday suit.
No, you said anything.
Well,
you said anything.
That would be an awesome party. Oh, superhero party.
What you gonna have close your bow tie on?
Close your eyes. So this is welcome to the NFC Chronicles.
Shit, and y'all ain't saying nothing. If you come like that, it'll be a hot ass show. You gonna take one for the team?
I come with a.
I try to boost them up.
I will sit like this, butt naked on the TV.
He won't be sitting in my chair.
I dare you.
He better bring a chair.
He got to bring his own shit. You don't want no ball juice on your chair.
He's got OC.
He don't want no goddamn ball juice on his chair.
There won't be no tea bag juice on my chair.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Not have
goddamn.
No tea bag juice on his
chair. Like you say, your own chair shit. But nah, we got to put it together, but I want y'all to come dressed as your favorite hero.
Oh.
I guess I'm daring y'all. I better send that memo out to Rich, too. I don't know what Monday we're going to do it. Y'all let me know when y'all get y'all costumes and shit together, and then we can do it. I think that'll be a hot-ass show. Because I don't need a reason to put a costume in.
Shit, we can do a post saying if you was a superhero, what the fuck would be your superpower?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Anything.
Let me tell you.
Anything.
I just read, no lie, when you just said that, did you hear about the pastor that was having the female congregation give him oral sex, and he claims that the sperm was the holy milk, that's how the spirit of God can get into you through his sperm? No lie.
I'm not saying that's not true, but there again is such a misuse of power. You know what I'm saying? And then the women had to be in such a weakened state of mind to even buy into it.
I mean, they were showing videos of women damn near like spitting up and shit because he said that this was the holy milk.
I mean, that's deep.
Oof.
Yeah, that's deep.
I mean, we you know what? I wonder if we should get on the topic of preachers and what they're doing to these churches. There's a preacher right now.
But we have
that has a sermon out that I found out is out right now, and the sermon is called "The Gospel According to Rudolph." We talking about the reindeer. Ain't that a bitch? Now we're doing sermons on reindeers now?
Well,
we're doing sermons on reindeer. So I guess for Valentine's Day, the gospel according to Cupid.
The funny thing that you should mention that, because I grew up in Bethel, and I remember one of the ministers there, it was his trial sermon, and he preached on the three little pigs.
The three little pigs.
And I was sitting up in the pulpit, youth choir, and I remember saying, I think for that split second, I probably forgot I was in church. I said, is this motherfucker talking about the three little pigs?
The three little pigs. Are you serious?
It blew my mind.
He got that deep into it?
He really went, and I was trying to stay with him, because you know sometimes you got to go with a motherfucker on it to see where they're going. But he lost me, okay. He lost me on that, and I was blown away that he used that. If he could have tied it to something, he would have had me. But he lost me.
And I heard that the gospel according to Rudolph, he got into the reindeer. He got into the three wise men. Not the three wise men. I heard he got into the story of the reindeer. He got into the story of the song. Rudolph and those reindeer. The whole song. I mean, he got into the whole thing.
All right, we got to wrap it up. So I want to thank each and every one of you on Facebook, Instagram for listening. Congratulations again to Bridget Nunez as our Valentine's Day giveaway recipient.
Thanks, Bridget!
See you next week. We'll be giving away another gift bag. I'll post the qualifications. Until then, y'all have a great week, and we'll see you next Monday. Good night.
Deuces!